This video is brought to you by Sketchfab, a platform for buying and selling 3D models online. Their store has a lot of high-quality models to choose from using a great model inspector. Links in the description. In the world of 3D computer graphics, there is an infinite number of 3D models and basic geometry and forms that everyone is familiar with, including a teapot that seems very ordinary on the surface, but actually it is more important than you think. This teapot was basically used for testing rendering software and their features in addition to simulations and dynamics. It is so famous to the extent that it became part of the primitive geometry in software such as 3ds Max, AutoCAD, Houdini, Lightwave, and much more. It became so popular to the extent that VFX artists and animation studios has been including it in their animation projects as an Easter egg for those who pay attention and know its history. For example, it appeared in one episode of The Simpsons, also one of the first and most popular animation movies, Toy Story. In addition to that, it was used in old Windows PC screensaver and many other films and games over the years. The teapot model was created in 1997 by the early computer graphics researcher Martin Newell, a member of the pioneering graphics program at the University of Utah. It was one of the first to be modeled using Bezier curve rather than precisely measured. Newell had some novel ideas for algorithms that could realistically display 3D shapes, rendering complex effects like shadows, reflective textures, or rotations that reveal obscure surfaces, but he struggled to find a digitized object worthy of his methods. Objects that were typically used for simulating reflections, like a chess pawn, a donut, and an urn, were too simple. For his work, Newell needed a simple mathematical model for a familiar object. His wife, Sandra Newell, suggested modeling their teapot since they were sitting down for tea at the time. He sketched the teapot using graph paper and a pencil. Following that, he went back to the computer laboratory and edited Bezier control points by hand. It was the perfect choice. The curves, the handle, lid, and spout of the teapot all conspired to make it an ideal object for the graphical experiments. And like other objects, the teapot could, for instance, cast a shadow on itself in several places. The new model was particularly appealing to Newell's colleagues. Jim Blinn, one day demonstrating how the software could adjust an object's height, Blinn flattened the teapot a bit and decided he liked the look of the new version better, and the distinctive Utah teapot was born. Newell made the mathematical data that described the teapot's geometry publicly available, and soon other researchers began to use the same data for their computer graphics experiments. These researchers actually needed something with roughly the same characteristics that Newell had, and using the teapot data meant they did not have to create geometric data for the same object, although technical progress has meant that the rendering of the teapot is no longer the challenge it was in 1997. The teapot continued to be used as a reference object for increasingly advanced graphics techniques. Over the following decades, editions of the computer graphics journals regularly featured versions of the teapot, faceted or smooth shaded, wireframe, bumpy, translucent, refractive, even leopard skin and furry teapots were created. Having no surface to represent its base, the original teapot model was not intended to be seen from below. The real version of the teapot is 33% taller than the computer model. Jim Blinn stated that he scaled the model on the vertical axis during a demo in the lab to demonstrate that he could manipulate it. They preferred the appearance of the new version and decided to save the file out of that appearance. The original physical teapot was purchased from ZCMI in 1997, and it was donated to the Boston Computer Museum in 1994, where it was on display until 1990. It now resides in the ephemera collection at the Computer History Museum in Mountain View, California, where it is cataloged as a teapot used for computer graphics rendering. Versions of the teapot are still sold today in Germany by the original makers of the teapot. Through 3D printing, the Utah teapot has come full circle from being a computer model based on an actual teapot to being an actual teapot based on the computer model. It is widely available in many renderings in different materials, from small plastic knickknacks to fully functional ceramic teapot. It is sometimes intentionally rendered as a low-poly object to celebrate the origin of the computer model. In 2009, the Belgian design studio Enfold 3D printed the Utah teapot in ceramic with the objective of returning the iconographic teapot to its roots as a piece of functional dishware while showing its status as an icon of the digital world. Newell has jokingly lamented that, despite all his algorithmic innovations, he will be remembered primarily for that damn teapot. But as much as computer scientists try to prove their chops by inventing clever algorithms, testbeds for experimentations often leave a bigger mark. I hope you found this video useful and informative. If you have something to add, you can leave it in the comment section below. Also, you can check some of our previous videos. Thank you very much, and I'll see you in the next one.